focuses on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Tech. Well, we have with us Dr. R. N. Tandon, who is the Secretary General of IMA. Sir, first of all, I would like to know tell me about this seminar. Like, it's a doctor-patient relationship, but we can hardly see any patient here.
No, we are discussing doctor-patient relationship. What are the reasons why the doctor-patient relationship is deteriorating, I'll say. At least we have recognized there is probably a problem. And we tend to think and discuss. You may not see patients, but one thing is assured. Even the LG was telling in his inaugural speech that he has seen hospital as a patient, he has seen the hospital as an attendant, as a friend visiting a patient. So everybody in the gathering is basically a patient. Don't think about that, they are not patient. Everyone is a patient in some other fashion, whether they have suffered a disease and got admitted, or got in touch with a doctor, or they have visited hospital. That is something different. But the important thing is that we are discussing this not only with the medical people, we have all persons from society. The first lecture which we have started now is the professor of sociology from Delhi University. She is PhD and she is going to talk about on this doctor-patient relationship. Then your doctor is talking about doctor-patient relationship. Then you'll ultimately have a media person. Vinod Dua is here. He'll be talking about doctor-patient relationship. Then there is the Chief Justice, Jay Krishna. He is going to speak about doctor-patient relationship. So everybody from all certain part of our life is there in the discussion. So we want to come out with the reasons and what to do and how to improve the relationship and with doctor and a patient. One thing I can assure you, all over the world, recently we visited China where we had this kind of a discussion on a doctor-patient relationship and the violence and ethics. So the most important, the glaring thing which came into the light is the media has to play a positive role in improving the relationship between the doctor and patient. So the media has got a maximum role to do everything to improve the relationship. Because one thing one has to understand, if at all there is a problem with of a patient against a doctor or against the establishment, you have so many things. You have so many platforms, whether the CPA is there, whether the civil court is there, whether the criminal court is there. You can do anything. You can go anywhere. But everybody is requesting, and the LG has requested, there's no reason that you should take law in your hand and you should assault a doctor or assault establishment. The Chief Minister of Goa has said on two occasions, even the Prime Minister has said, the Supreme Court has said, don't put doctor under pressure. They cannot give you the best if they are under pressure. If a sword is hanging on their head, how can they work? So these are the things everybody has to realize. And when assault takes place, what happens? You're assaulting a doctor. Then the doctors are trying to protect themselves, then they will ask for protection, they will not work. And what is happening? Because of one patient and one family, risk others, 100 patients, 1,000 patients are suffering because of this assault, this kind of thing. So we are trying to look into the reason, and we are interested in improving the healthcare by all means. We want to have a better relationship so that there is no problem for the patient, no problem for the medical profession. Because once we are free, we are working with a free mind, without any fear, then probably we'll give 100%. Otherwise, under fear, you'd he may attack on us if something goes on. Then you are not ready to take this. So who is suffering ultimately because of all these things? The community and the patient.
At last, I would like to ask you, how close we are finding a permanent solution for this?
Yeah, it's so difficult to find out any permanent solution. The idea of this seminar and this discussion is that we should come out with certain guidelines. These are the guidelines which are going to help us in self-regulating our establishment and developing a relationship with the patients and try to protect our doctors from assault. Because this is not a good thing. We have become a doctor not to receive such kind of bashing for not of our fault. I tell you, most of the times, wherever the assault is taking place, this is none of the fault of a doctor. The things are altogether different. You don't have infrastructure, you don't have support staff, you don't have other facilities which you are supposed to provide, you don't have the number of doctors who can manage really the huge number. The governor was also asking, there's so much of load of a patient. So these are the factors for which a doctor is assaulting. That's not right.
Thank you.